In this video, we'll focus on the following data transformation techniques: partitioning, missing value imputation, normalization, and conversion. If you have studied a bit of machine learning, you know that a machine learning algorithm is trained on a training set and evaluated on a different test set that doesn't overlap. This operation of creating two disjoint data sets from the original data set, one for training and one for testing, is called partitioning. In KNIME Analytics platform, partitioning can be implemented, for example, by the partitioning node, according to one of the following sampling strategies. Random sampling extracts data randomly from the original data set. It is the standard sampling strategy. Stratified sampling also extracts data randomly from the original data set, but following an a priori distribution of the values in a selected nominal feature. In this way, the final data sets will have the same value distribution of that feature as the original data set. This strategy is often selected for classification tasks to make sure that both training set and test set have the same a priori distribution of the target class values as the original data set. This is particularly important when you have a strong class imbalance, as it ensures that the minority class is represented sufficiently in both sets. The take from the top strategy reserves the top data rows for the training set and the bottom data rows for the test set. If the data rows are stored by time in an ascending order, then the training set will contain the past samples and the test set the future samples. That's why this sampling is used for time series analysis, because it preserves the time order. Note that it shouldn't be used with classification or regression models, because random sampling guarantees the presence of all types of samples in both sets. Linear sampling extracts one sample for every n samples. It is not random. Instead, it aims at creating subsets that contain all types of samples from the original data. Partitioning should be the first step you take in data preparation. Indeed, in order to avoid train-test contamination, which can cause inadequately optimistic model evaluation, all further data transformations should be performed exclusively on the training set and then only applied to the test set. The next data preparation step, although not necessarily the second one, is missing value imputation. Some algorithms can't handle missing values, or they perform worse with missing values in their training data. Missing values can also decrease the clarity of a dashboard. There are many ways to deal with missing values. The missing value node implements most of them either by column type or column name, where the latter overwrites the first setting. More complex imputation strategies, based, for example, on the training of a machine learning model, must be explicitly implemented. In extreme cases, columns with more than a set percentage of missing values can be completely removed using the missing value column filter node. Next, we move into encoding categorical features, which might be required by some algorithms, such as logistic regression or neural networks, which can only handle numeric input. Encoding of categorical features ranges from a simple conversion to numerical values to index coding and one-hot encoding. The simple type conversion to numerical values is obtained with the string-to-number node. We can perform one-hot encoding with the one-to-many node. It transforms all values in a categorical column into many columns with headers from the values in the original column. The column cells are then filled with 1 or 0. 1 indicates the presence and 0 the absence of that value in the original column. Notice, though, that this operation can create a huge sparse feature space. Therefore, this step is the last, following data cleaning and reduction. Another encoding technique, index encoding, means mapping each nominal value to a number. This technique is especially useful with ordinal columns, and we can do it with the category to number node. Note that in KNIME, many learner nodes for machine learning accept string columns as input, even though the algorithm only processes numeric data. For example, the logistic regression learner node accepts categorical input columns because the node automatically transforms them into multiple encoded columns. The last data preprocessing step that we introduce in this video is normalization. Some machine learning algorithms require normalized data. If the algorithm involves a distance or a variance measure, then the data need to be normalized. Otherwise, non-normalized features with larger ranges dominate the algorithm execution. For example, the principal component analysis is based on a variance measure. Linear regression is based on a mean squared error, and most clustering procedures are based on a distance measure. Besides those, neural networks also require an input in the 0-1 range. With the normalizer node, we can perform three types of normalization. Min-max, a linear transformation of the data from the original range into a new selected range, such as 0 and 1. Z-score, a linear transformation of the data from the original distribution into a normal Gaussian distribution with mean 0 and standard deviation 1. Decimal scaling, a non-linear transformation of the data obtained by recursively dividing the data values by 10 until all values fit into the range negative 1 to 1. Now we have to perform the same data preprocessing steps separately on the test set. So does this mean that we'll need to repeat all the steps twice? Luckily not. Many techniques, such as normalization and missing value imputation, have their dedicated apply nodes, which apply the same operations with the same parameters on the test data or any other new data. In this video, we have introduced partitioning, missing value imputation, conversion, and normalization as common data preparation techniques before training a machine learning model. We have introduced theory behind each technique and shown the nodes you can use for each task. Explore this further by trying out the workflow. Just follow the link attached to this video.